Now, kingfishers. Most of the kingfishers of the world live near what?
Water.
Rivers.
No, they don't.
Forest fishers?
No, most of the kingfishers in Britain live near water.
They live near a certain...
Yeah, but most of the kingfishers in the world
sea.
Don't. No, not near water at all.
Well, why are they called kingfishers?
Because that's a British word for them. Because we, in Britain, see them by the river.
Well, they're called kingfishers all over the world.
No, they're called halcyon in Greek. Not called. What do think they're called?
Well, that's just the Greek for kingfisher.
Halcyon, exactly, but it doesn't mean fisher.
There it is, fishing.
It's in Britain.
In Britain. Fishing again.
In Britain.
He does, I mean, the evidence is there
Britain,
behind
you. In Britain, not tradition, it
is. If you go to
somewhere
Africa,
that isn't Britain.
Africa.
For example.
Well, I've seen a kingfisher that not anywhere near a river, you're right.
Yeah, they mostly, right. In Africa.
All like this.
Yes, no, it was.
Mostly in Africa, they live in disused termite nests.
It looked lost.
They live in disused termite nests.
You haven't got a fish on your head, Bill,
have you? Yes. It's a river around here, isn't it? Water, really?
What is the colour of that kingfisher?
It's so turquoisey, really, isn't it?
It's turquoise. Brown.
It's brown?
Yeah.
This programme's getting more and more...
It is actually a sort of optical illusion. In fact, the actual colour pigment is brown, but it iridesces.
Well, I must remember, I'll go to the middle of the Sahara Desert and get one, and then put it in a darkened room and see what colour it is.
Yeah.
Perfect. So, but
just because it's not near a river doesn't mean it's in the Sahara Desert. Just because it's not near a river doesn't mean it's in the Sahara Desert.